next speaker is going to narrate how technology can help finance professionals. I'm sure that it would be a quality information worth investing time. I personally take clues from very small things. The Amzer or Sage, they have been associated with us for quite a long. I keep going to quite a many seminars and I get quite a few pens, branded pens with the company. But one thing I can declare, that in past so many years, the best pen in terms of looks and quality, they run till the end without any interruption, are from Sage. So I believe, I am not a tech savvy person, but I believe that when they take that minute care of giving a good name to their brand, a good quality to their brand, definitely they are going to serve you good information. Mr. Raghav Fernandez, our next speaker, is Middle East Regional Director of Sage, a multinational enterprise software company. Having more than 20 years of experience in the IT industry, Raji is an expert in corporate management with a vast knowledge of ERPs and CRMs. Raji is a frequent guest speaker and commentator at small and medium enterprises related conferences because SMEs are Sage's specialist area. So ladies and gentlemen, technology, how it can help finance, I welcome Mr. Raji Fernandez. Can I request CA Khushbu to please come and hand over a bouquet to our speaker?
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Good afternoon, right? I just said good morning so that we be in the morning, we all fresh. Yeah. And it starts with a good day, good morning. You know, you start in the office, you start going, good morning, good morning, good morning. Yeah. Well, this is a difficult topic for me. I'm a business guy like you. But, you know, today I'm taking a topic that, though I'm a technology guy, but, you know, is it for techie guys? I'm not a coder, etc. So the topic is, how is your business a technology-led business? Yeah. And is your business disruptive? This is a message I want to communicate today to you. It's something different, but it's very powerful. And you know, I hope in the 30 minutes that I am presenting to you, you will get some information which you could take and implement in your organizations, in your offices. So as we all know, we are an information era. Yeah, we all know for the last 20 years, it's an IT boom and all those things happening. But is our business really in the information era? Is one thing that you need to ask. We still operate in the industrial era business. What do I mean by that here? Where in the industrial era business, you have to invest more money to get more business. You have to invest in more people to grow your business. You have to invest in more tools and machineries to expand your business. So it was more for more. But today, with less or the same, you can also grow your business. And that's where the mind shift is happening. So what's important for us today, and all people in all sorts of businesses, is to have a mindset shift, though we are in the era already, to have a mindset shift from moving our businesses from an industrial era business to an information age business. And this is very important. Today, we still think we have to invest logically or physically into a place and other things. But digitally, we can change the way the world is going through. So what is the new reality that we're facing today, okay? We believe with the influx of technology, it's not going to be business as usual. If you have been successful for the last 20 years, the chances of you being successful in the next 5 years are less. Okay, forget 20 years, if 5 years, 1 year back, technology is changing the landscape. We call it digital disruption. It is changing the way business has been done. and what was proven as a standard and a good, dedicated, a proven formula for success of a business even a year or two back is now questionable. And this is a thought that you need to take today and see how you could make your business disruptive in a sense that it can help you grow your business. Innovation is the key for sustainability and growth. This is something that has to be an integral part of your organization. You can't take the same product and say that it's going to be serving you for a lifetime. So you need to see how you want to innovate, how you want to market it, how you want to position it, what are the benefits your customers and customers are going to get from it. So these are the areas that you need to look and address. The biggest mistake you can do is if you fail to adopt technology to your business, it may not exist in a few years' time, or you know. So it's very important. And the biggest challenges today business organizations have is to see how they can adopt technology for their business so that they can grow and most importantly sustain their business over the next decade or so. So what I'm going to talk to you about something is called digital disruption, and this is what is changing the landscape of the business. Now, what is digital disruption and how it is going to impact you as an individual and you as an organization? Today, technology, and I have a couple of videos for you because I know it was afternoon session, so I thought, you know, I'm not a very good orator per se, so I thought I will have some videos for you to keep you awake. Yeah, all of us like to see movies, right? So I'll have some technology movies for you, provided the technology works here. I'm not too sure, but I think it's working, right? Kapil spent his lunchtime making sure that it works, so I'm sure it will work. Yeah. So companies are seeking to align digital strategy. It's very important. They do it in isolation. And I think that integrated approach, like what Bipin just mentioned about challenges of integration. I think integration is the key today for whatever we do in our businesses, whether in technology, whether in compliance, etc. So things like cloud, mobility, this may sound buzzwords for you. You know, some may ask you why there's no sun. Cloud means something that is stored somewhere. It's not on your premises. The software is running somewhere else. Social media, analytics, and e-commerce. And these are the four or five factors that you need to consider if you take your current traditional business and try to use these four or five factors and see how it can affect your business, how you can use this and how you can grow and leverage your business. So now let's put the technology to test. I hope the volume, everything is fine. And let's see the first video. There you go. Okay, it's good because tomorrow I'll be a Bill Gates or Steve Jobs, yeah? Because whenever they do big presentations, you know, something happens, okay? Is it? I'm making me nervous now, huh? The reason I brought these videos is because pictures can say much more than words, yeah? No. Has created a state of perpetual revolution. Digital disruption explodes the status quo, rewrites economics. Doesn't matter. We still have three videos, so don't worry. One doesn't work, the second one will work. If second one doesn't work, the third one will work, yeah? Come on. Was it? Unfortunately, I can't speak Malayalam, but it's, you know. Yes, and it always works. You know, this was done with a purpose, you know, to wake you all up. Yeah?
Yes.
Now it's working? Let me see. It went?
Disruption. It used to happen occasionally.
Increase the volume.
Every so often, A social or economic upheaval would change the way people thought, connected, and did business. Then along came the internet, and bam, everything changed. Because technology has created a state of perpetual revolution.
Okay, I'll order.
Digital disruption explodes the status quo, rewrites economics, scrambles supply chains, and blurs category boundaries. It also pushes a business into new dimensions while questioning its very survival. Every industry faces disruption, but not in the same way. As our Digital Disruption Index shows, change to your sector could be some way off, or it could be on a much shorter fuse. And the impact could be small, or a much bigger bang. Some businesses will emerge stronger, while others encounter heavier weather. The trick is in knowing how you'll be impacted and being thoughtful in your response. It starts with breaking down the problem. To be a digital survivor, there are three broad responses available to you. So, what are your options? Let's start with cost. Here's your cost structure, and here's that of your new digital competitor. Feel threatened? Well, how can you get more competitive? You could streamline your supply chain, replace bricks and mortar with e-tail, and cut warehousing by having products made just in time. Or save on people costs by automating your training and recruitment. Putting your admin in the cloud could save you money and create a more mobile, flexible workforce. Now, about your revenue. It's drying up. How can you replenish it? Replace your old sources with new ones before you really feel the heat. Digital lets you target new sectors and customers in a more granular way. You can also access new geographies. Adopt radical business models yourself. You could also shift things around at the level of your corporate strategy. Which of your assets are declining in value and ripe for divestment while you invest in new ones for growth? What about the new risks of the digital landscape? And could the risks of inaction be even greater? Does your business have the capacity to act decisively and fast?
Okay, there's technology for you anyway. The audio video, but I hope you got the message. Some companies has to evolve slowly, some fast. You saw the big blast, the finance tree. The audio wasn't right, but I think the next video is more, visual, so you'll be able to see it's all writing on the wall or something that way, okay? But it's important to understand that the impact technology is having. Today, banking is some of the bankers are having a challenge because things like PayPal has made it very easy to transact businesses. Okay, you can transfer money, you have open a website, you put a PayPal account, and it transfers to PayPal, it becomes a global digital bank that it can take forward to you. So let's see how we can put technology to better use in your business. Now here is a list which is definitely not a comprehensive list, but I just thought I'll add some of these areas so that you can, and give you some tips here how you could use technology in these areas to improve your organization's performance. In terms of business planning, it's very important not only in terms of budgeting and planning, but I think to having it with controls like Bipin mentioned and checking up with check and balances and KPIs from bottom-up approach. But also in terms of products and services, the planning on inventory management and other things are very important. All of us deals with products and services. So most of the time, this planning and forecasting what to order, when to order, with whom to order, is done based on experience and not on technology, based on past trends, etc. So tools like those, which are really, some of them are really free if you really go to see. Most of the best thing about technology today is most of it can be available at a very low cost, so that you can implement it, try it out, and then go on the full blast. Marketing. With technology, you can change the landscape of marketing. We at Sage now had stopped really printing our brochures because our digital brochure is really awesome. If you like the pens, you should see our brochure. It's really amazing. you know, it's on the web. You could browse it, and it looked like you're really reading a proper brochure. Yeah? So it's very important that you leverage technology, and it is cheap because in printing, you have to spend a lot of money, and it's also green. You know, you save on the environment in those areas. So marketing today is also changing. Technology is changing marketing in a big way. I do not know about your mailer communication. You get, you know, so the various tools which are free, one of them is AWeber, which you, I think some of you must be using it, where you can schedule your communications automatically to your customers on a weekly, monthly, you know, basis, so that you can plan instead of doing a mail blast every now and then. So a lot of tools are available for you to really use in these areas. Service levels is another place where technology can play a very important things. There is a, I'm just giving a few names here, but these are not our Sage products, but just for you to use. To get a feedback from the customer today is very easy. All you have to use a product called SurveyMonkey. Yeah, it's free. And you go and check up or get a feedback. I use it quite often, yeah, you know, just to get a few impacts. You can go for a paid version also, but you know, you get a service, you can check it up, and it's very easy to use. So you can use technology to improve your service level, to automate and to accelerate immediately. Like somebody said, red flags during the previous session. So if something is not serviced within the particular period of time, you know, then you can flag it off to the top management or to the concerned person. So things like those can be taken forward much easier and much faster. You could also work on building efficiency and processes within the organization. Yeah, you can do that by time, we have no problems. So you can build efficiency, and this is very important. If you do not have, like earlier, the previous session you saw about compliance, corporate governance, etc. Now all this, and the biggest challenge you have, the control and the risk, which I was listening to very attentively this afternoon. And if you have a system in place that can be put and mapped all these controls that we're talking about and give you the KPIs and indication and exceptions as it happens, wouldn't it be a wonderful tool for you to control and to really you know, put things in place? So in terms of business process efficiency today, you know, there was a survey conducted, and you know, we found that a good 60% of the potential of an employee is not utilized by the organization, because most of the time they do things which can be done much shorter, much faster, and with less time, because they take much more time to do that. Yeah, and this is a biggest challenge that we have. You know, so that's what I said in earlier, with the same team, you could grow our business. And I just, and the living example is in our company, over the last 1 year, we had a management change, and with the same employee, almost 90% of the same employees, we grew our business by 46% in a year's time, in IT business, yeah? So it is really possible to do this by having right technology and right processes in place. Employee empowerment is another place where you can automate things in a big way. All of you do appraisals, etc. You know, but the appraisals are done once and then they're kept in the file. At the end of the year, the HR manager comes out and says, oh, here's your appraisal. What did you achieve or no? Small tools are available to define objectives on the web, and you can integrate them, and they are alerted that these are the objectives, these are the timelines. So your appraisal of your employees can really become more productive, rather than just at the end of the year. Also, you can empower employee by various tools to automate and to speed up the availability and the deliverability to the business. Anyway, this is this, you can watch it. Yeah, it's a bit interactive, so you can watch it.
Heard the word digital? You know what that is too. But put them together, digital disruption, and they add up to much more than the mere sum of their parts. Digital disruption, when properly understood, should terrify you. There are three sources of digital power. One, free digital tools that can rapidly build new products and services. Two, digital platforms which can be exploited by competitors. And three, a burgeoning class of digital consumers. These three sources are unleashing a disruptive force that will completely alter every business on the planet. Consider the case of Weight Watchers. They were disrupted after spending decades and hundreds of millions of dollars creating their customer base. But in just 4 years, a tiny 8-person digitally disruptive company sucked 13 million customers from their market with an app called Lose It.
What makes digital disruption so much better, stronger, and faster than old disruption? Under old disruption, very few people had access to the capital necessary to develop new ideas, so very few ideas were brought to the market. That all changed with digital disruption, where many people have access to digital tools that allow them to bring many more ideas to market at a fraction of the cost. Consider the math. Even if there's only 10 times the innovators, and one look at Kickstarter will tell you it's much more than that, and even if we assume that they're only operating at 1/10 the cost, and you multiply those two conservative estimates together, we're talking 100 times the idea power with digital disruption. So, how do you protect yourself from digital disruptors? You copy their behaviors and mindset. Digital disruptors are intensely customer-focused. You're probably thinking, we're already customer-focused, but in truth, most companies just offer customers low-cost and incremental product improvements. But with free or nearly free digital platforms and tools, you can offer your customers much more value at a very low cost. So stop using your old processes and expensive analog tools and start obsessing over the question, how can we serve our customers better, faster, and cheaper? In the old world, we'd ask ourselves, what does my customer want? Then we'd create the product and quickly build a brick wall around the customer by making the cost of switching to another provider extremely high. Under digital disruption, we actually tear down that wall because our job is to ally with the customer. We do this by helping them look for things outside of the current product experience that they might be interested in. As you look through your customer's eyes, you can determine which of these adjacent offerings you have the resources and skills to act on. Through this new vantage point, you'll generate more ideas more quickly. Don't build a future. Build the next thing people really need, and that future will find you. Another disruptive behavior involves creating digital enhancements to amplify the total product experience. Here's how UPS did it. They started an online program called My Choice that gives customers added flexibility by allowing them to do things like scheduling delivery and rerouting packages. And since people have to sign up for the program, UPS created a digital bridge allowing them to communicate with 3 million customers who opted in. With this bridge, UPS can test and deliver new offerings to improve the total product experience. What else can you do to become a digital disruptor? You can remake your company's culture by embracing the digital disruptor's mindset and driving home this message. This is how we operate now. We identify customer needs. We rapidly test and deploy solutions. We measure them, and then we do it over again. Digital disruptors are so successful today because they build better customer experiences faster and cheaper. Embrace their mindset and disrupt the disruptors.
Okay, so this video, you know, gives you a good idea of what one or two companies have done. Yeah, UPS is a good example where you use technology, which is just a website with a portal where you could go in and register and give conveyance about your route, etc., and they have upped their services. So what I'm saying here is, and this is very important, so in your areas of your business, yeah, and sometimes in most organizations, because I interact mostly with finance people, and finance people play a very vital role in an organization, especially in decisions of investments and other things. And through this, you could also play a role of using technology to really build and advise the management in terms of how it can be used. Now, these are some of the areas that we just mentioned here. But, you know, you may be in manufacturing. In fact, the earlier video, you must have not got the message. It was about different industries and, you know, how they're changing and what can be done, etc. But you pick up any area, and the way we look at it is, you need to pick up an area that can have crucial impact in your organization. If there is something to do delay with shipments, or it is a delay in your response to your customers, take that area, look at it, Google it, yeah? Don't come to Sage, you can come, of course, but, you know, Google it and find out how you can address this problem. And please, it doesn't require a lot of investment. You know, I did the Brazil example I gave to you. One of the ways we increased our revenue by 46% is because we had an appraisal form in which every year we do it. So I went and I brought a tool from the web because I wanted it to be productive and objective based. I went and I brought a pool for $1,000 and I got all my employees, and now everybody's objectives are in the system. And you know, and 1 month objective, 3 months. And what's interesting is that you get alerts, etc. But the impact it had on my employees and my staff is tremendous, because everybody wants to put his objective in small. You know, it's like making a presentation is an objective. Some people have 20, 30 objectives, which are, because it's improving their company. You know, they think one is small areas, which earlier they would have forgotten, because maybe there's an increment at the end of the 6 months or what a year. But they have done a lot. And it's just not the management change, etc., but the employees have contributed. And I've seen that happening in my organization. So take a small thing, small area, and see how you can change it. Yeah, use, try it out, and it's with technology today, you've seen it is most of the tools are available free. So it doesn't require a huge investment. Yeah, and you know, I would really appreciate if you have done something like this, you will share it with me, because you know, this is I'm into this business of, you know, how technologies can help people. So if you try something, and a smaller thing, and organize, and it has got maximum impact in your organization, please share it with us, and you know, and I would really like to take it forward from there. So this is not a sales speech right now, but I just wanted to tell you from Sage perspective, we have taken disruptive digital disruption and seen how we can provide a solution. So though we are into ERPs, but we also have enterprise intelligence and all those things, cloud computing, etc., which we can talk about. But right now I'm not talking about that, but just to give you an overview, okay? And the intention is not here to sell the solutions, etc., but just to tell you that we are working with the technology to see how we can enhance our solutions. We still don't have the full pie out. In HR we are missing out, but you know, the inventory advisor is very important. With whatever ERPs you use, you can still use it and optimize and get your return on investment for a small $500, you know, based on SKU. You can get your return on investment on optimizing your inventory, etc. So that's not, but I just wanted to give you another last video. But before that, I want to share some statistics. We engaged a company called IDG Connect to provide a survey of what are the key things, this disruptive technology, does it really work? Does it have a pings in the Middle East? Okay, and I will quickly share some of the statistics. This can be downloaded. You can contact us, and we can. It's a white paper with about 30 pages on technology, etc. And you know, we can maybe ask you know, Sanjay Gupta, if you want to share with our members, you can do it. Yeah, it's our products. We just did a research to identify what are the trends, and what we found out is the four trends, which actually my presentation is all about in the future, but you know, where we believe the integration with then a solution should be with, if you're trading, inventory optimization, business intelligence integration, mobility is very important today. Yeah? Today, desktop is a dying, you know, desktop is gone, it's dead already, laptop, I mean, yeah, is a dying tool. A few years back, laptop was a top tool. Yeah, today, tablets and you know, mobile phones are the way forward, okay? So the last video, which is important, which is my favorite, and I really hope it works this time, yeah? Because this is how we at Sage would like to change everybody's life. This is our vision our vision is to help our customers, to give the customers a freedom to succeed by ensuring that the back office products and services are safe and secure, and providing them the right impetus to grow the business. So here, look at a day in the life of a businessman from the Sage eyes. Yeah.
Come on, boy. Come get your breakfast. Come on.
See you when I get home, okay? Yeah, I'm heading to the new showroom right now. I'll be back in the office later this morning.
Sage Advisor is recommending we go with a maker depreciation method.
That sounds great. Thank you.
Okay.
I like it. You get it.
I love this.
And what's great about Sage is you can see all of your choices together in your kitchen.
Kitchen is going to look amazing.
And with a Sage Advisor, you can see here that your mobile and CRM services volume is through the roof. Frankly, I recommend that you upgrade as soon as possible.
Okay, well, let's do it.
Right, sounds great.
Okay.
Daddy, when are you coming home?
I'll be home soon, honey. I'll get to sleep in a few minutes.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Doing a great job.
Thanks. Abigail's asleep now. She's had a busy day.
Okay, so that was a day in the life of a businessman and how technology can help him. Yeah. We're not ready yet with that, yeah, I mean, and from Sage perspective, but that's our vision. That's what we want to do. So wherever you are, whether you're driving, you're meeting somebody, you're talking to somebody, business can be transacted as it happens. Yeah. So this is where we are moving for. Also, very soon, we are coming out in the Middle East, something called Sage Advice, which is nothing to do business, but to advise people on various aspects. And we want people like you to help us in the forum where we share information to small and medium-sized enterprises on finance, on marketing, on customer service, on customer retentions, and other things on all the other areas. Okay, I think I have before my 25 minutes. So I'm before he shows me the internal control. That was right. Whatever. Yeah. So I'll skip some of the slides. But this is all part of our presentation earlier. For some of you who do not know Sage, we are the third largest business solution provider in the world, which very few people know. We are after SAP and Oracle, okay? But in the SME space, we are number one in worldwide, yeah? In the Middle East, we are fourth, yeah? But our ambition is to be number one in the next 5 years. And this is our solution offering, so for all sizes of companies. Now, this is very important because this is where the video is all about, okay? We have smaller products called Sage 50 and ECRM and X3, which is a bigger product. But the layer that is very important, visual processes, intelligence, all that is combined. It's available on choice and mobility, net cash, and everything. So we give you a complete solution offering, okay? And I would like to introduce our partners, MServ. I think they're here. Okay, MServ has been our partners in Bahrain, and they have been a partners for a long years, and they've been our strong supporters on Sage Solutions, and they have a good team here. So they also have the solution. They help us complete our solution, like the payroll, et cetera, is, you know, we don't promote payroll because each country has specific needs. So they provide solutions around the areas to help complete Sage. Yeah. So with this, I would like to thank you very much for your time. I tried to condense the whole presentation, you know, which was for 1 hour 45 minutes to 30 minutes. I hope I've been able to do justice. But, you know, if you try to use technology and if you need some, you know, ideas, et cetera, please feel free to contact me. And, you know, I and my team can help you. It may not necessarily be with a Sage product, but at least some tools available that can help you in your business. Thank you very much. And I would like to thank the Bahrain chapter for and Sanjay Gupta for inviting us and giving us the opportunity. It's always a pleasure to be with you all. You know, I started my career as an accountant as a profession, but I was not as smart as you all. So I choose the easy route of becoming an IT selling accounting software. Yeah? So that's how I have been. But it's always a pleasure. And you know, what I like about the Bahrain chapter is it's much more livelier than the Dubai chapter. Dubai has this little bit aura, you know, because I'm not saying this to please you, by the way, because we do work with them also. But, you know, they're big guys. Oh, I don't know. When Dubai is big, yeah? Burj Khalifa and other things. So they have their, you know, here I find, because this is my second or third time I think I'm here, and, you know, people are friendly, and it's really nice, yeah? It makes me feel very comfortable, yeah? So I'm sure we will do much more things with you all in the near future. Thank you very much.